Hi students, today we have to study the third example from the practice set 6.2. The question is, we have given the two buildings on the road which is 12 meter in width. We have two buildings in front of each other on a road which is 12 meter in width. If we observe the second building from the top of the first building, if we observe the second building from the top of the first building which is 10 meter high, the angle of elevation obtained, that is 60 degree, the angle of elevation obtained, that is 60 degree, then find the height of the second building. We have to find the height of the second building, and we have given the height of the first building, that is 10 meter. See, first of all, while solving the word problems or the problems belongs to the heights and distances, in the first step we have to draw the diagram, in the second step we have to write the description, and into the third step we have to write the information which is available, and we have to use the trigonometric ratios to get the value which required. So you can solve any word problem using these three steps. So first we will draw a diagram according to the conditions given in the example. Here it is given that we have two buildings on a road. Suppose this is a road which is 12 meter in width. This is the width of the road. Length is not given. Only we have given the width of that road. On this road, two buildings are facing each other. Two buildings are in front of each other. Now see, we have two buildings. It's the first building and let it be second building. Now maybe some students have question why the first building is smaller and the second building is higher than the first building. Because in the example it is given that if we observe the second building from the top of the first building, the angle of elevation is made. If we observe the second building from the top of the first building, the angle of elevation is made. And we know that when the angle of elevation is formed, if we observe above the horizontal line, then we get the angle of elevation. It means that the first building is smaller and the second building is the higher than the first building. So here we have given that, see, suppose these segments represent first building, we will represent this segment as AB, we will represent this point C. So BC is a road having width 12 meter, AB is the first building, and we will represent this point as D, and CD is the second building. Now from the top of the first building, if we observe the top of the second building, then the angle of elevation of 60 degree is made. That is given information. So here we have to draw the horizontal first. This is the horizontal, which is always parallel to the ground or floor. Horizontal line is always parallel to the ground level or the floor, and or the ground you can say. And here the angle of elevation, see, this is the horizontal line, and if we observe above the horizontal line, then the angle of elevation is made here at this point, and this angle measures 60 degree. That is the given information. This angle measures 60 degree. Height of the first building is 10 meter. Height of the first building is 10 meter, width of the road is given 12 meter, and we have to find the height of the second building. Now we draw the diagram. Now we have to write the description there. We draw the diagram. In this diagram, AB is the first building, CD is the second building, BC is a road having 12 meter width, and this angle AD will represent this point as E, angle DAE. that is the angle of elevation which is 60 degree. So this is all about the diagram, and here this is very important information, both the buildings are perpendicular to the ground or to the road. Two things are very important, each and every object which is given into the example, we have to consider that it is always perpendicular to the ground or floor. And second one, always we have to neglect the height of the person. Now suppose here we have a person which is observing the top of the second building from the top of the first building, but we have to neglect the height of that person. That is very important. Sometimes in the question the height is given, the height of the person is given, at that time we have to use that height also. We have to consider that height and we have to get the answer of the question according to that height of the person. So here we complete the diagram, we plot the diagram, we draw the diagram, and now we have to write the description of the diagram. Here seg AB, seg AB is first building, then seg CD is the second building, seg CD is the second building, then seg BC, seg BC is a road. This is all about the description of this diagram. Now we have to write in the third step, we have to write the information, we have to write the information which we have available here. We know this length of seg AB, we know the length of seg BC, we know the measurement of this angle of elevation, and we have to find the height of the second building. So here the information which is available with us, that we have to write here in the above figure, in the above figure AB is equal to 10 meter, BC is equal to 12 meter, angle DAE is equal to 60 degree. This is not necessary to write, this is not important to write. The angle ABC is 90 degree and angle BCD is 90 degree, that is not necessary to write there. Always the buildings are perpendicular to the ground level or floor or to this road. Now the information what we have, that we write here, and now what we have to find, we have to find CD, that is the height of the second building. We have to find the length of segment CD. Now if we observe this figure carefully, if we observe this diagram carefully, we will get that this quadrilateral A, B, C, E is a rectangle. See, two opposite sides are parallel to each other, and if any one angle is right angle, then definitely that quadrilateral is rectangle. We do not have to prove there that it is a rectangle. We need not to write the proof why it is rectangle. Just we have to write it is rectangle and we have to get the values. Now suppose if it is a rectangle, now see BC is equal to 12, so definitely we can write AE is equal to 12 meter. This is very important. If BC is equal to 12 meter, then definitely AE is equal to 12 meter, because opposite sides of rectangle are congruent. Now here if AB is equal to 10, then definitely CE is equal to 10. Now this much part we get here, that is CE is equal to 10 meter. Now just we have to find this part, that is segment DE. And once we get the length of segment DE, then CE plus DE, that is equal to CD by using the relation of betweenness. So it is too easy. But remember, this quadrilateral is rectangle when the opposite sides of quadrilateral are parallel to each other and one of the four angle is right angle, at that time that quadrilateral is said to be rectangle. And if it is rectangle, then opposite sides are congruent. AB is equal to 10, therefore CE is equal to 10, BC is equal to 12, therefore EE is equal to 12. And now using this right angle triangle, this angle also measures 90 degree. These two lines are parallel to each other and these are the corresponding angles, so it measures 90 degree. And now using this right angle triangle, just we have to find the length of DE. Now we know the adjacent side and we have to find the opposite side. So we have to use tan or cot ratio again. And we have to get the value of DE. But before going to this triangle, we have to write that it is a rectangle and we have to get the measurements of CE and EE. Because if we don't know the length of EE, then we cannot find length of DE. One of the side of the triangle we have to know, and if we get one side of the right angle triangle, then definitely we can get the remaining two sides of that right angle triangle. But at least one side we have to get. And we get this side as 12 meter by using this concept that quadrilateral ABCE is rectangle. So first of all, we will write the information about this rectangle, this quadrilateral ABCE is a rectangle. Therefore, we can write AB is equal to CE is equal to 10. AB is equal to CE is equal to 10 meter. And also we can write BC is equal to AE is equal to 12 meters. BC is equal to AE is equal to 12 meter. And the reason of this is opposite sides of rectangle. Opposite sides of rectangle are congruent. The opposite sides of rectangle are of equal length. Now we have to think about this triangle. We have to think about this triangle. And in this right angle triangle, we know the adjacent side and we have to find the opposite side. So in this right angle triangle, we have to use tan ratio of this angle 60 degree and we have to get the length of DE. And once we get DE, then CE plus DE is the height of the second building. That is too easy. So here we will write in right triangle ADE, in right triangle AED, we have angle DAE is equal to 60 degree. So here you can write tan 60 degree is equal to, how we write the tan ratio? That is opposite side upon adjacent side. Opposite side is DE upon adjacent side is AE. Now put the values there. Tan 60 is root 3. Nothing is there in the denominator, means we have 1 there. DE we have to find, so we will write DE as it is, and AE that is 12. So we write 12 here. So now we have to simplify this. DE into 1 is DE, that is equal to 12 multiplied by root 3. And since we do not have the value of root 3, no need to write the value there. So we have DE is equal to 12 multiplied by root 3, that is 12 root 3 meter. And here we do not have the value of root 3. We know the value, that is 1.73. We use that value in the second example, but here in the third example, the information about the value of root 3 is not given, so we are not using that value. You can simply write DE is equal to 12 root 3 meter. But this is not the answer of our question. What is the question? We have to find the height of the second building. Just we get this part DE, that is 12 root 3, and now we have to add this part to DE, so you will get the height of the building. So here you can write DC is equal to DE plus CE. DC is equal to DE plus CE, and the reason is, what is the reason behind it? That is relation of betweenness. DC is equal to DE plus CE, and the reason is E is in between D and C. So you can write like this, DC is equal to DE plus CE. Put the values there. DC is equal to, the value of DE is 12 root 3 plus CE is equal to 10. This is our final answer, or you can take 2 as common from both the terms. You can take 2. Here we have 12, here we have 10. Both the numbers are divisible by 2. So you can take 2 as common. So DC is equals to 2 into the bracket 6 root 3 plus 5 meters. And now you can write the final answer into the words, that is height of the second building. Therefore, height of the second building, height of the second building is 2 into the bracket 6 root 3 plus 5 meters. And that is all about the example number 3rd. We will take next example, that is example number 4. Example number 4 from the practice set 6.2. The question is, two poles are erected on the ground. Two poles of heights 18 meter and 7 meter are erected on the ground, and the length of the wire, which is attached to the both the tops of the poles, that is 22 meters in length. And here we have to find the measurement of the angle made by the wire with the horizontal. See, according to question, we have to draw the diagram first, then we have to describe the diagram, we have to write the description of the diagram, and then we have to write the information which is available there, and we have to use the trigonometric ratio there to find the value which is required, which we have to find. So here, according to given information, two poles are erected on the ground, and two poles are erected on the ground. This is first pole, and let it be second pole. Two poles are erected on the ground. This is 18 meter and this is 7 meter in height. Two poles are erected on the ground of the heights 18 meter and 7 meter, and a wire is tied, a wire is fastened, or the wire is tied to the top of both the poles. The top of the both the poles were tied by the wire, and the length of this wire is 22 meter, that is given information. Now we have to find the angle made by this wire with the horizontal. We have to find the measurement of the angle. We have to find the measurement of the angle made by this wire with the horizontal. This is horizontal, or you can draw this horizontal here also. Both the angles are having same measurement because they are alternate angles made by the transversal of two parallel lines. So here we have, it is easy to find this angle because this angle is equal to this angle. If we draw the horizontal here, the measurement of the angle is same. But this angle is included inside the diagram, so you can easily find the measurement of this angle. But to find the measurement of this angle here, if we draw the horizontal, that is not too easy. So we will find the measurement of this angle, which is the angle made by the wire with the horizontal. It is given that this is height of this building is 18 meter, first building, this is 18 meter in height. Height of this second building is 7 meter, that is given information. And both the poles are erected on the ground. So both are parallel to the, both are perpendicular to the ground. Now here we have to find the measurement of this angle. So we will represent, we will give the names to the each and every vertex. Here we will represent this first pole by PQ, and we will represent this pole, second pole, by RS. This is the ground level, and this is horizontal. We have to represent here a point, we'll represent it as P, Q, R, S and T. We will represent this point as T. And now we have to find this angle. See, the question is very different. I think this is one and only one example in this exercise, which is odd or which is different example as compared to the other examples, because here we have to find the angle. Here we have to find the measurement of the angle. In all other examples, we have to either find the length of segment. There is no angle we have to find in other examples, but in this example we have to find measurement of this angle. So we have to get at least two sides of this triangle. See, this is right angle triangle. Definitely it is right angle triangle. This is horizontal line which is parallel to the ground level, and these two angles are corresponding angles. This is right angle, so this angle is also right angle. And in this right angle triangle, we know the measurement of the hypotenuse. Now we have to get the measurement of one of the two sides, either side PT or side RT. We have to get the measurement of one of the side. And once we get the measurement of any side, then you can easily get this angle by using the trigonometric ratio. If the angle is given, we are able to find the remaining sides. And if you know the sides, then definitely we can find the measurement of this angle. But at least two sides we have to know. One side we know, this is PR is 22 meter in length. Now we have to find either PT or RT, and then comparing that sides with the trigonometric ratio, out of 6 we have to use any one trigonometry there. The ratio is depend upon the sides which we knows. So here we have PR 22 meter. Now we have to find either PT or TR. So we draw the diagram, we plot the diagram, we have to description, we have to write the description, we have to describe the diagram. Here seg PQ is a pole, then seg RS is another pole. We have given two poles which are erected on the ground. First one is PQ and second one is RS. Then this is PR, seg PR is a wire tied to the poles or to the top of the poles. Or you can easily write seg PR is wire only. This is not necessary to write where it is tied. Just it is a wire. So you can write only this much, seg PR is a wire tied to the poles. That is not necessary to write there. Now here we write the description also. Here we write the description of the diagram also. And now third and last steps, in which we have to write the information which is available with us and the information which we have to find or which we have to require the information we have to write there. And then we have to use the trigonometric ratio and we have to find the measurement of this angle. So here we will write the information which we have available. Here we have PQ is equal to 18 meter in the above figure. In the above figure, PQ is given 18 meter. Then we have RS is equal to 7 meter. Then we have PR is equal to 22 meter. And we have to find the measurement of this angle. So we will represent that measurement of angle by theta. So here we will write let measurement of angle TRQ is equal to theta, and we have to find the value of theta. But already we discussed about that. If you want, if you have to find the measurement of one of the angle of the triangle, then definitely we have to get at least two sides, length of the two sides of the triangle. Here we know the one side, we have to get one more side, and you can easily get the measurement of this side TR. Easily we can get. See, this is rectangle, and we know that the opposite sides of rectangle are of equal measure. This total height from this point to this point, it is 18 meter given. Now see, this, if this is right angle, this is rectangle, then the opposite sides are congruent. So if it measures 7, then this is also 7. TQ is 7, since the opposite sides of rectangle are congruent. Now you can easily say that this is 11 meter. Total length is 18 meter, total height is 18 meter, out of this TQ is 7, so remaining part is 11 meter. Easily we can write, and now we know the two sides of the right angle triangle, so you can easily get the measurement of this angle theta. Easily we can get, but before that we have to write this part, that we have to find the length of PT here. So we will first write this quadrilateral is rectangle TQSR. Quadrilateral TQSR is rectangle. So we can write RS is equal to TQ is equal to 7 meter. RS is equal to TQ is equal to 7 meter, and the reason is opposite sides of rectangle. Opposite sides of rectangle. Now we have to get this length PT, and you can easily find this length by using the relation of betweenness, that is T is in between P and Q. So you can write PT plus TQ, it is equal to PQ. Here we can write PT plus TQ, it is equal to PQ, and the reason is T is in between P and Q. T is in between P and Q. Put the values which we know, PT we have to find, TQ it is 7, here we get TQ is equal to 7, it is equal to PQ is 18. So we get PT is equal to 11 meters. This is very important value, second side of the right angle triangle. And now we can easily get the measurement of this angle PRT, which we represent as theta. As we have to find the value of theta, what we know in this triangle, we know the opposite side. We know the opposite side of angle theta, and we know the hypotenuse. Now tell me the ratios. Now you have to tell me the ratio which is related with the opposite side and hypotenuse. That is either sine or cosec. That is either sine or cosec. We know the opposite side, we know the hypotenuse. So you can use any one ratio, that is sine ratio or cos ratio. So in this right angle triangle, we will use sine ratio there. So in right triangle PTR, in right triangle PTR, we have to write sine ratio. We have to use sine ratio. Sine theta is equal to, how to write sine ratio? Opposite side upon hypotenuse. The definition of the sine ratio is opposite side, PT upon hypotenuse is PR. So here you can write PT upon PR. Now put the values which we knows. We didn't know the measurement of angle theta, so we will write sine theta as it is. It is equal to, what is the value of PT? Just we find here, this is 11 meter, divided by, what is the value of PR? The value of PR is given 22. And now you can simplify this ratio. This is 11 ones are 11, 11 twos are 22, and we have sine theta is equal to 1 upon 2. Now we have to look towards the trigonometric table. In that trigonometric table, the value of which angle of sine ratio is half, and that is 30 degree. this we get sin theta is equal to half, this information we get, and from the table we have sin 30 is equal to half. This is from the table. Reason of this part is from the table, it is given in the table that sin 30 is equal to half. Now you can easily compare these two. Here we have sin, here sin, equal to sin is there, equal to sin is there, half, half, just in place of theta we have 30 degree. So you can write by comparison, theta is equal to 30 degree. Now you can easily write your answer into the words, that is measurement of the angle made by the wire with the horizontal is 30 degree. Measurement of the angle, measurement of angle made by wire with the horizontal, is 30 degree. And this is all about the example number 4, and it is very important example because this is one and only one example in which we have to find the measurement of the angle, and it is too easy. Nothing is different there in this example, just question is different. The method of asking the question is different. In each and every example we have given the measurement of the angle and we have to get one of the side. And here we have given the measurement of the sides and we have to find the measurement of the angle. That is the difference between the other questions and this question. So no, nothing is hard in this example. अवघड असं या एक्झाम्पलमध्ये काहीच नाही आहे. पण बऱ्याचशा वेळा असं होतं, फाईंड द मेजरमेंट ऑफ द अँगल म्हटलं कीच बरेचसे विद्यार्थी ते क्वेश्चनला कशाप्रकारे सिम्प्लिफाय करता येईल त्याचाही विचार करत नाहीत. बट त्याला घाबरण्याची आवश्यकता नाही आहे, मेथड सगळी सेम आहे. फर्स्ट स्टेपमध्ये आपण डायग्राम ड्रॉ केली, सेकंड स्टेपमध्ये आपण डिस्क्रिप्शन लिहिलं, आणि थर्ड स्टेपमध्ये जी इन्फॉर्मेशन आपल्याकडे अवेलेबल आहे ती लिहून योग्य त्या ट्रिगोनॉमेट्रिक रेशिओचा यूज करून आपण त्या अँगलचं मेजरमेंट फाईंड केलेलं. फक्त हे इम्पॉर्टंट आहे, आपल्याला साईन थिटाची व्हॅल्यू हाफ मिळाली. मग ट्रिगोनॉमेट्रिक टेबलमध्ये असा कोणता अँगल आहे ज्याची साईन रेशिओची व्हॅल्यू 1/2 आहे, आणि तो आहे साईन 30, दॅट इज इक्वल टू हाफ. सो बाय द कंपॅरिझन थिटा इज इक्वल टू 30 डिग्री. नाऊ वी विल टेक नेक्स्ट एक्झाम्पल, एक्झाम्पल नंबर 5. Example number 5 from practice set 6.2. The question is, a tree is broken due to the storm. And the broken part is rested at the width of 20 meter. The broken part is rested on the ground at a distance of 20 meter from the base of the tree, and that broken part made an angle of 60 degree. With the horizontal. Then find the height of the tree. And here we have given the angle which is made with the horizontal, that is very important thing. So first we will draw the diagram, then we will write the description, and into the third step we have to use the trigonometric ratio and we have to find the answer of the question. So according to given information, we have given a tree. Suppose this is the tree which is perpendicular to the ground. This is ground and this is tree, and this tree is broken. We will consider, suppose this tree is broken from this point. And the broken part is rested on the ground. The part which is broken, the same part is here which is rested on the ground. And the distance between the base and this top after breaking the tree that is given 20 meter. This is the tree which is broken from this point due to the wind, due to the storm. And see, we have given the angle of elevation with the horizontal, that is very important. This is not horizontal. Here we have to draw the horizontal where the tree is broken, and we have given that this angle measures 60 degree. If this angle measures 60 degree, then definitely this angle is also 60 degree, but we cannot directly write the measurement of this angle as 60 degree. According to the example, according to the question, we have given the measurement of this angle which is made by the tree, the broken part, with the horizontal, and this angle is given 60 degree. If it measures 60 degree, this is also 60 degree. So we will represent, we will give the names AB. This total AB is a tree, and that tree is broken from this point. So we will represent this point as C, and this top rest on the ground at a distance of 20 meter from the base. So we will represent this point as D. Now see, AC is equal to DC. Why? AC is equal to DC. That is very important thing, because anyhow we cannot find the length of AC. But we know that AC is equal to CD. This same part is broken. This part which is broken, that part is rested on the ground. So this part is only broken here and rested on the ground. So AC is equal to CD. That we have to remember carefully, and that is very important thing. Now here we know the measurement of this segment. You can find both the sides of this right angle triangle. You can easily find both the sides of the right angle triangle. If you know one side, we can get all the sides. We can find all the sides of triangle. This is the unbroken part and this is the broken part, and sum of these two parts is nothing but that is the height of the tree. This is very important information. Unbroken part and broken part, we can easily get both the values because we know BD. In this right angle triangle CBD, we know the measurement of a side. So you can easily get the measurements of remaining two sides. One side is nothing but that is the unbroken part of the tree, and the another part is broken part of that tree, and sum of broken and unbroken part, that is equal to height of the tree. And here now we plot the diagram. We have to write the description here. In this diagram, this is seg BA, or you can write AB, is a tree. Then BC is unbroken part. Seg BC is unbroken part of the tree. And AC or CD, that is the same part. Before breaking the tree, that part is in this situation, and after breaking the tree, same part is in this situation. So AC is equal to CD is equal to broken part of the tree. Here you can write seg AC or seg CD. Broken part is broken part of the tree. Now this is all about the description. You can write this also, seg BD, distance between the base of the tree and the top of the tree after breaking the tree, but that is not necessary to write here, and if you want to write, you can write there. Now we draw the diagram, we write the description, and now third and last step, the information whatever we have to write here, and the information which we have to get, what we require to find that we have to write here. So here we have BD is equal to 20 meter in the above figure. In the above figure, we have to represent one more point here. We will represent it as E. We have given the measurement of this angle DCE or ECD 60 degree. So you can directly write angle ECD is equals to angle CDB is equals to 60 degree, and the reason is alternate angles made by the transversal of two parallel lines. Alternate angles. Actually, we have given the measurement of this angle made by a tree with the horizontal, and if this angle measures 60, then definitely it is 60 degree. Then we know seg BD is equals to 20 meter, and what we have to find? We have to find AB, measurement of seg AB. So here we will write seg AB is equals to question mark, that we have to find. And how we have to find? This is the unbroken part and this is the broken part. We have to get the length of both the sides and we have to take the sum. So you will get the height of the tree, but this is equals to, this AC is equals to CD. So we are going to find CD only, and that CD is equals to AC. You can write that here, AC is equal to CD. Why? Same part. This is before the storm and this is after the storm, that is broken part. The tree is broken by the storm. So after breaking the tree, this is converted into CD. So AC is equals to CD. This same part here we are already write AC or CD are the broken part. Now in this triangle we have to find BC and CD. So we can write in right triangle, in right triangle CBD. See, we know the adjacent side and we have to find the opposite side. We know the adjacent side of this angle, that is 20 meter, and we have to get the opposite side. So you will use tan ratio there. Tan 60 degree is equals to opposite side is BC upon adjacent side is BD, and put the values there. Tan 60 is root 3, nothing is there in the denominator, means we have 1 there. BC we have to find, so BC is as it is upon BD, it is given 20. Now take the cross multiplications, we will get the value of BC. BC is equal to 20 root 3. BC is equal to 20 root 3 meter. Now we have to find CD. We have to find CD. Now here we know the adjacent side and we have to find the hypotenuse. We know the adjacent side and we have to find the hypotenuse. So which two ratios are related with the adjacent side and hypotenuse, that is cos or sec, that is cos ratio or sec ratio. So we will use cos 60 degree. Cos 60 degree is equals to, how you can write cos ratio? Is adjacent side upon hypotenuse. Adjacent side is BD and hypotenuse is CD. So we will write BD upon CD here. Cos 60 degree is equals to BD upon CD. Now put the values there. Cos 60, that is equal to half. Cos 60 is equal to half. And BD is 20. And we have to find CD. CD into 1, that is CD is equal to 20 into 2 is 40 meter. CD is equal to 40 meter. And now we know that CD is equal to AC. So here you can write CD is equal to AC is equal to 40 meter. And now we can easily find the measurement of seg AB, that is height of the tree. AB is equal to AC plus BC. AB is equal to AC plus BC, and the reason is सी इज इन बिटवीन ए एंड बी, सी इज इन बिटवीन ए एंड बी, पुट द वैल्यूज देयर, ए बी इज इक्वल्स टू ए सी इज 40 प्लस बी सी इज 20√3. So the total height of the tree is 40 plus 20√3. The value of square root of 3 is not given. If it is given, we have to use that value, but the value of root 3 is not given. So this is our final answer, or you can take 20, but you cannot write it as 40 plus 20, 60√3. See, this is an irrational number. This is rational number, and we cannot add a rational and a irrational number. This is very important thing. Or sometimes some students write 40 plus 20, that is 60 into root 3 as it is. That is wrong. We cannot add a rational number and an irrational number. You can take 20 as common, but no need to take 20 common. We will write it as it is. That is, AB is equal to 40 plus 20√3 meters. And now write the final answer. Height of the tree is, height of the tree is 40 plus 20√3 meters. So this is all about the example number 5. Now we will take last example from this practice set, that is example number 6. Example number 6 from the practice set 6.2, which is last example from this practice set. The question is, a kite is flying at a height of 60 meter from the ground. A kite is flying at a height of 60 meter from the ground. The string attached to the kite makes an angle of 60° with the ground where it is tied to the ground. The angle made by the string with the point where the string is tied, that angle measures 60°. And now the question is, find the length of the string, assuming that the string is straight. Assuming that the string is straight, there is no slack. Actually, if we see the kite flying, the scene that where the kite is flying, the string is not straight. There is a slack in the string, but we have to assume that the string is straight, and we have to find the length of the string. So we will represent that situation into the diagram first, then we will describe the diagram, and then we will solve the question. We will write the information which we have available and the value which we have to find. So here first we will draw the diagram. See, suppose this is a ground, and from the ground a kite is flying at a height. Suppose at this point we have a kite which is flying at a height of 60 meter, the height where the kite is flying, that height is given 60 meter. Here we have this point as kite. The height of the kite from the ground level, that is 60 meter. Now the string attached to this kite, the string attached to this kite makes an angle of 60° with the ground. That is very important thing, not with the horizontal. The string which is tied on the ground, that string makes an angle of 60° with the ground. So this angle measures 60°. And now we have to find the length of this string, assuming that the string is straight. Actually, जर आपण प्रत्यक्षात असं दृश्य पाहिलं तर आपल्या असं लक्षात येतं की पतंगाला बांधलेली जी दोरी असते ती अशा प्रकारे स्लॅक्स असतात त्यामध्ये, असा बाक पडलेला असतो, तर स्ट्रेट कधीच नसते ते, परंतु ती स्ट्रेट आहे, ती स्ट्रिंग स्ट्रेट आहे असं समजून आपल्याला त्याची लेंथ फाइंड करायची आहे. सो दॅट इज व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट. सो वी ड्रॉ द डायग्राम हियर. नाऊ वी हॅव टू नेम द पॉइंट्स अँड सेगमेंट्स हियर. वी विल रिप्रेझेंट दिस पॉइंट बाय के ॲज इट इज काइट. वी विल रिप्रेझेंट इट बाय युझिंग द वर्टेक्स के. दिस इज एल अँड दिस इज M. Now, say KL is height of the kite from the ground. Point K is a kite. And point M, the point where the kite is tied. The point on the ground where the kite is tied. So, we'll describe the diagram here. Say KL is height of kite from the ground. Then this seg km is, this is string. Seg km is string. Then point K, that is a kite. The actual position of the kite in the sky, and here the string of the kite is tied. So if you write the description, or if you do not write the description, it is not making any difference there. So if you want to write, you can write, and it is not necessary to write, but the angle is made there, so you can write point M where the kite is tied. This is not necessary to write, but we can write there. Now this is diagram, this is description. Now the information what we have available, that we have to write here in the above figure. We have KL is equal to 60 meter. We have angle LMK is equal to 60 degree. And we have to find KM. Now, with reference to this angle, we know the opposite side, and we have to find the hypotenuse. So about which trigonometric ratio we have to think? Opposite side and hypotenuse. So we have sine or cosec ratio used there. We have to use the sine ratio or cosec ratio. So here you can write, in right triangle KLM, sine 60 degree, that is opposite side KL upon hypotenuse KM. And now put the values there. Sine 60 is square root of 3 upon 2. KL is 60, and KM we have to find. Now take the cross multiplications. Root 3 into KM, that is equal to 2 multiplied by 60, it is equal to 120. Transfer this root 3 to the right side to find the KM. So we will get 120 upon root 3. Now we have to make the rationalization of denominator, since the denominator is irrational. So we have to multiply numerator and denominator by root 3. So we have KM is equal to 120 into root 3 divided by 3. This is 3 4s are 12, 3 0s are 0. We have KM is equal to 40 root 3. But in this example, we have given the value of root 3 as 1.73. So we'll put that value here. Root 3 is equal to 1.73. That is the given information. So here you can write KM is equal to 40 multiplied by 1.73. Now take the product. This 0 remains as it is here. Now multiply this 1.73 by 4. 4 3s are 12, 1 carat, 4 7s are 28 plus 1, 29, 2 carat, 4 1s are 4 plus 2, 6, And after two digits, we have to give the decimal sign here. And it is 69.2 meters. That is the length of the string attached to the kite. So, we will write the final answer here into the words. Length of string attached to the kite. Attached to the kite is 69.2 meters. So, that is all about the example number 6, and here we complete the practice set.